So, hi friends, and welcome to Crick Vidya's cricket podcast. And today we'll be reviewing the first T20 between India and England that happened yesterday, and also discussing what changes in approach or team 11 both teams need to make going forward. So, to discuss this, I have with me my co-founder Yasir. Hey, hi. Yasir.
Hi.
So, Yasir, a predictable start from India. Lose the first game, give over confidence to the other team, and then probably come back hard. Do you think it was that, or was it that they could not really win it because England was better?
So, I think multiple factors, Sunit. I also believe because India is not trying. So, batting first, setting up the score is the possible weakness that this Indian T20 team has. And they were trying a different mode of playing. And that showed in the way players got out. So, I was expecting this to some extent, especially if India was batting first.
So, do you think that India is trying to do the right thing, but with the wrong set of players? Or you think that these players can do it, just that because a new approach is being tried, they failed for the first time?
I think role becomes important, Sunit. For instance, I believe that Virat Kohli is an outstanding anchor player. Now, if he tries to go from the ball one, and I think we have seen that in IPL as well, he mishits on certain occasions. So that is one point. Second thing is, while I agree with this concept that in T20 you have to keep on hitting, and that is England is the perfect example for that. But conditions do have an important say, and pitch is a very important variable. So the ball was the pitch was a little too paced. It was pretty evident, and it was not easy to start hitting right from the beginning. And that's why somebody like Shreyas Iyer did very well. So in India, you will get multiple pitches, different pitches. For instance, Australia, you know, there are certain category of flat pitches, more or less. You get 190 plus scores very easily. That is not necessarily true. Here, the par score may have been 150, 160. So all those things have to be considered.
No, but if you look at what England did, I think 150, 160 would still have been a below par score.
Yeah.
So in that sense, if they were trying to get 150, it would still have been not enough. So 180 kind of a score was required. But then you've not answered my question. Do you think they are playing with the right set of players?
No. So the So if you ask me, Rohit Sharma has to come. I personally don't see a debate between Shikhar Dhawan and KL Rahul. KL Rahul, especially if he's in the attacking mode. I'm not talking about the conservative mode that he has taken in the IPL in the last two seasons. But if he's in the attacking mode, he is, after Hardik Pandya, I think the best T20 batsman we have. Right. So it is important who comes in where, in what position and what role they are playing. For instance, if you have KL Rahul and Rohit Sharma, then one has to definitely be attacking, let's say, KL. And Rohit is in the relatively anchor mode. Now, if KL gets out, then you need to send Pant in so that then you still have one anchor and one attacking mode. You can't have two anchors playing together for sure. So you can't have Virat Kohli in anchor mode and Rohit Sharma in an anchor mode.
Rohit Sharma can obviously change gears.
So then it has to be very clear that Rohit Sharma changes gear. And he then goes, he does not take time. So those things have to be taken into account.
So now India have one headache, another headache, that the only player who was in question and and everybody was saying that you should change him is the only one who has performed in the first ODI.
Right.
So what do they do? Do they bring in Surya Kumar Yadav for the second game? They can't obviously now ask Shreyas Iyer to rest or take out Shreyas Iyer.
Right.
So you think now they can bring in Surya Kumar, or you think he'll have to wait for a bit more?
So it is important. What are we looking for from this five T20 series? See, personally, I am okay if we lose all the five matches. but we are then sure what kind of approach we are going to have going into the World Cup. And if, because this is possibly the last set of matches, international T20 matches that we are playing. So if we are clear as to what we want to achieve, then I am even okay with the fact that Virat Kohli drops himself and we have Surya Kumar Yadav playing, because we need to give a player like Surya Kumar Yadav a chance to express himself. Otherwise, how will we know how is he, and we have to give him matches.
But then you're saying losing all five matches. If you are losing all five, I don't think you would be able to finalize the strategy, because it has to be a winning strategy, right? So
then you know what is not working for you. Okay, yeah. I'll put it that way.
But then you don't know what will work, right? So that is also a problem.
So Sunit, I was looking at one stat. Since 2018, in all completed T20 international matches, India has the best win-loss ratio at 2.15. They are the number one. And the number two team is England at 1.88. So even with the conservative strategy, yes, that strategy has some flaws in it. Even with the conservative strategy, India has done pretty well in T20 international bilateral matches.
Okay. So, great. So now let's move to that. Again, I'll ask you the same question. Going into the second T20, should India change anything or just give this combination one more go? So that they can, again, the approach was clear, but it didn't come out to be successful. So maybe it'll come out to be successful this time.
So Sunit, I'll take your view first and take your feedback, and then probably I'll give my input as well.
So I think there could be, I said that in our preview also, that there could be an option to try Ishan Kishan also as an opener. So that is one thing, that if they are looking at him just as a replacement for or a backup for Pant, then obviously he has to be groomed to play at number four, number five only. But if they are looking to see that he can be a backup opener, then it brings firepower in the beginning. But from what we have heard from Kohli, I think he's the backup keeper only, so they can't really. And he's clearly said that Shikhar Dhawan is our third opener, and Shikhar Dhawan will be the backup opener. So in that sense, if Rohit Sharma is rested, you give these openers a go once more, and then the clear understanding is there that you will have KL and Rohit Sharma as your first preferred opening pair. Kohli comes at three, and then four. Now it is a problem that you have to give Shreyas Iyer some more matches. And if he's playing, I don't think Surya Kumar has a place in the squad. So you can win and rest somebody. But if you're losing and then taking him out of the team, then you are clearly saying that we are trying a new combination, and this is now what we want to try. So in that sense, I think they'll go with the same kind of approach in the second match. Just that they could, three spinners versus two spinners at the bowling wise is something that they can look at changing.
Right. So my view would be that because they have already committed, I think Kohli committed that Shikhar has to play. I mean, they will rest Rohit for two matches. So I'm assuming tomorrow as well, same opening combination will play, but we never know. A day before the match, this Kohli said very clearly that our preferred openers are Rohit and KL. So I don't know, but my guess is they will give him another chance, obviously. And bowling, I will not be too harsh, Sunit, frankly, because this was a much below par score, so there's not much to defend, and there's nothing that bowlers can do much, frankly.
But let's come to bowling, and we'll discuss Indian bowling first. So, I was still a bit of a surprise that they did not start with Washington Sundar. So, Washington Sundar coming in at after power play, then you're saying that I think the main use of Washington Sundar as a bowler is as an opening bowler in the power play when England is trying to attack, and because of his line and length. he might be able to get people out, or if you are defending a low score, he won't be giving out runs.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think they missed a trick there. Yeah. They started with openers. The only thing that I can think of, the reason was that there were two right-handers and they wanted Akshar Patel, who takes the ball away. But as I've said before, I think this matchups and ball going away has been a little overrated, and Kohli has been in the past known for holding back Chahal also, who is like one of the best spinners. And if left-handers are playing, he did not complete his quota of overs. Mm. So in that sense, I think that was something that I might want to change. That that is clear that the two right-hander openers will always come. Even if Butler is not coming, Bairstow will open. So England now have two right-handers opening. So are we saying that Washington Sundar will not bowl if there are two right-handers opening? So I think that's a questionable strategy. And they need to relook at that. And obviously, if Natarajan kind of a player is available for the second ODI, he comes in.
Yeah.
So that can be the second change in terms of the bowling options. But if you're going with three spinners, the strategy needs to be relooked at.
Yeah, I agree with you, Sunit. And in IPL as well, Washington Sundar has bowled reasonably well to right-handers. Predominantly, he ends up bowling to right-handers. So I just feel that Kohli had a bit of a hangover from the test, in the sense that Akshar Patel in the past couple of matches was opening prior bowling, and more or less, and sort of that trend continued. And I definitely feel Washington Sundar is best utilized as a power play bowler, and that gives you so much flexibility. I mean, in a full strength squad, if Washington Sundar is giving you two or even three overs in power play, that gives you a lot of firepower in terms of Bumrah and Natarajan at the back end or even in the middle overs.
And also another decision that I would like to question here is that Pant came in at number four. Now, another big discussion in batting order is that there should be a right-hander, left-hander playing. And Shikhar Dhawan was already there, and you send Pant in at number four. So maybe Shreyas Iyer could have been sent there, and that would have, I don't know, maybe changed the course of a match a little bit. But again, something to think about.
So Sunit, my perspective on this is, when we are batting first and we are setting up a total, I believe Pant has to be in the top four. And because you are trying to maximize overs to Pant, because obviously we know players like Pant and even Pandya can strike, go at a much higher strike rate. So I would like to bring him early. So that perspective, I'm okay. But yeah, I mean, that decision has to be taken. And we have to also remember that while Pant is coming with good form, T20 is playing, internationally is playing after a long time. All those have to be factored in.
Okay, so now let's talk about from the England perspective. So bowling wise, I think the first good thing that they did was they changed their strategy of the opening bowler, and nobody really could have expected that Adil Rashid would bowl the first over.
Yeah.
So I think that was a really good move, and not thinking about he bowling to a left-hander and Shikhar Dhawan, like we said, that Chahal has been held back because they were left-handers at the crease. So they didn't think of that. They just thought that this could be a surprise. And they, with all like five more seam bowlers there. So that way, I think that was a good move. And then with something that was talked about on the commentary also, that out and out 149, 150 kilometers per hour kind of a pace bowler is always good. And they had two of them. So that was something that obviously India, when they have Bumrah, he comes back, and then they have Natarajan and Shami. So they'll have faster bowler. But as of now, England, in terms of fast bowling, have a very distinct advantage that they have those out and out pace bowlers, and India doesn't really have them.
So, Sunidhi, yeah, you're right. So, starting with, completely agree with you, and starting with leg spin and high pace is a very high rewarding aggressive strategy that Morgan employed. Frankly, yesterday's game, in all departments, including captaincy, including thinking, England were far, far better team. And it is just showing their white ball might as such. I know Mark Wood has bowled very well yesterday, but I will give, and we know Archer is no doubt a high elite fast bowler, but Mark Wood, while yes, he did bowl very well yesterday, the pitch also suited him because there was a bit too paced, and at back of length, it was difficult to hit. So I will not still rate Mark Wood that highly yet. I think we need to see more matches. And in fact, because we are just playing at one stadium, we may again be biased. We need a bigger sample because he has just played, while it's a very obviously a distorted sample, he just played one match for CSK in IPL. And he went for more than 12 runs per over. So, we need to give all this more time.
And also, do you think in terms of, let's say, Shikhar Dhawan, KL Rahul, Shreyas Iyer and Hardik Pandya, did they look rusty to you?
KL, yes. To some extent, Hardik as well, because Hardik has not been playing. He's with the squad. But he's not getting real match practice. So, they did look relatively rusty. And yes, it will take some time. And then, we know, India, on most occasion, ends up losing their first match. So,
so that's what. So, that one of the reasons of this loss can be given to that rustiness also. And I am pretty sure it will not be there for tomorrow's match now.
Yeah.
And we'll see a much better batting performance.
Yeah.
And I'd like to see still India batting first tomorrow and see how it goes.
Yes. Yes.
Because if they can win at least a couple of matches in this 5-match series batting first, that will give a lot of confidence to everybody.
Yeah, completely agree, Sunit. Because you don't know, in a T20 semi-final, you may lose the toss and bat first. And against a team like England or West Indies, who like to keep hitting. And even the toss may be against you, the due would be against you, and still you would have to try and win the match, right? So this is a good practice.
And from England's point of view, would you change anything going into the second match?
Not really, frankly. They had such a perfect game that unless they really want to try out some new players, I don't see any opportunity to really tinker with the side. And the only thing, maybe Sam Curran and Moeen Ali, if they feel the pitch is going to be slower. But yeah, that's the only debate.
So I think they are also waiting for pitch to wear down a bit. And then everybody was saying that for the last two matches or last three matches, it will become more suitable to spin. So in that sense, I think they are just keeping Moeen Ali for those matches. And going forward also in the World Cup, they'll look at the pitch and then decide their strategy. Because everybody believes that at least two spinners are required in your squad. So
Sunit, in fact, I mean, you're exactly right. And considering how prestigious this stadium is, I'm pretty certain that we'll have the finals and at least a one knockout match in this stadium only. So, the T20 final will probably be played in this game.
Could be true. So, that can happen. And now, I have a couple of more points to discuss. So, one was, Bala, who has been on our podcast quite a few times, he wrote on Twitter that maybe Kohli could be brought a little lower down the order. Because... he tends to become slow against spinners. So maybe if he's playing from 12th over or 13th over, where spinners would have only an over or two left and then it'll be pacers, he has been known to hit pace much more easily. So do you think there is there can be a situation where you would want that to happen.
So if we have a very strong opening partnership and they go at a very good run rate, etc., then maybe yes, you can think of shuffling your batting order. But otherwise, I'm not very sure about that. And I think it's about, again, like I said in the earlier part, it's about what combination is playing at the crease at that point of time, and that's important. So that has to be factored in.
Not as a permanent strategy. You would not want that to happen.
Not necessarily. I mean, it one off, yes, but not as a permanent strategy. Especially not if you are chasing. And maybe if you are setting up a score, you can think about it. But depending on the number of overs, what all resources are available, and all that.
And my second question to you would be, now how to utilize Surya Kumar Yadav?
This is a tough one. So ultimately, what is the intention of this series is what matters. If really, obviously, if you want to win all the matches, but if the intention is to try some players, because see, in a way, you know what Shreyas Iyer will give you. You know what Virat Kohli will give you. You know what even Hardik Pandya will give you, but we don't know what Surya Kumar Yadav can give you. So unless you give him 3 matches, and even if it is at the cost of a major player, you should do that. Because again, otherwise we'll just have the IPL once again for our reference.
So my theory is that Kohli will not play at least the last 2 matches and Rohit Sharma will captain. So
that's very highly possible. And so, that's why Surya Kumar Yadav may then...
So then Surya Kumar Yadav will play those matches and they might rest somebody, 1 or 2 more players, and then try out those players. So I think that has happened in some series, if I remember correctly. Kohli did not play last couple of matches.
I think India, New Zealand, the T20 series, which you had the tie matches.
So I think he will I think they'll shuffle Rohit and Kohli, because now for them, those 2 players are completely certain in the 11. So
Sunil, what happens, let's say theoretically, the first 3 matches we lose and then we win the last 2 matches under Rohit's captaincy. So that will be one interesting thing to ponder.
So that debate will obviously then come, that Rohit Sharma is a better captain, those kind of things. But I don't think now there can be a change in terms of captaincy at this juncture. Rohit Sharma is the vice captain, and I think those reports around these 2 players not going like they're not tally with each other, and those groups and those things, I don't think those are true. And there's a good camaraderie between them, and I think both are contributing to management decisions of the team. Yeah. So in that sense, Kohli remains captain, but I think if they want to try, the only way they can do it is maybe rest Kohli and Pant, or Kohli and Iyer rest, and both Ishan Kishan and Surya Kumar Yadav come in at some point. So
Pant, I would, Sunil, want to persist, because T20, again, he has not been getting a consistent run. So he needs to figure his T20 game, and we must realize it is not easy to play all the 3 formats. It is difficult even for a player like Pant, though he hit both Anderson and Jofra Archer for 6, but yeah, it's not easy.
So again, then the strategy could be that Shreyas Iyer and Virat Kohli are rested,
and
you have the other 2 players coming in, and that would be a good thing to see, because then you'll have the most of the Mumbai Indians playing.
And then Michael Vaughan's statement that Mumbai Indians is a better team than the BCCI.
So I think that is true. So I don't think there is a doubt in that, because
I think they're the best T20 team in the world.
In the world. So there was a Wisden poll also. I think there was before the start of previous IPL. And they said that they were also sure that Mumbai Indians are the best T20 side in the world. So can't really argue with that. If Michael Vaughan is saying it,
No, then he should add England to it as well. But yeah.
So yeah, in the world, then you're saying. So England, I think they would take a lot of confidence from this victory, and India need to really come back hard. It'll not be easy to beat them.
It'll not be easy. Yeah.
So especially batting first. So that will be something that they'll need to look at. And they should try to do that also, that batting first, they can beat England. They should have that confidence. Yeah. And obviously, at least a couple of matches, they will be chasing if we look at the odds. So one should expect them to win at least those two matches.
Yeah. I think, Sunit, looking forward to the T20 World Cup, I think the two teams who will challenge India, especially if India is batting first, are West Indies, full strength West Indies and England, because they have a very different approach to T20 cricket.
But yeah, from West Indies' point of view, you could have that strategy of they not being good against spinners, so that is there. But especially the time at which World Cup is happening, October, the dew factor will definitely be there because it'll be cooler then. So I think India needs to be prepared for that. So I think we'll close at that and let's get back after the second ODI and let's hope that it's 1-1, because from 2-0 to 3-2 would be a much difficult one to do for India.
Yeah. Thank you.
Chalo. Okay, Yasir. Bye. So guys, this was our analysis of the first T20. Please like and subscribe to our channel, and we'll be doing a review of each of the T20 matches, and we hope that India wins this series and gets that confidence before the T20 World Cup. Okay, bye, Yasir.
Bye.